Hi, everyone. My name is David, and I'm one of the product managers here at Confluent. Today, I'm super excited to show you what we've been up to when it comes to governing and discovering data in motion. So let's say you want to build a new streaming application and you're trying to search across hundreds of event streams on Confluent. Or you want to make some changes on a pipeline and need to understand all the downstream dependencies from a particular topic. Or say you have this auditor on your back asking you where on Confluent you store personal identifiable information. Well, these are all great questions, but today you're left with asking around the office, setting endless meetings to chase people, or keeping some of this information documented in medieval things like spreadsheets and intranet pages. As you might imagine, this is not productive or scalable, and we've seen this firsthand with some of our customers. As you grow your investments in event-driven architectures, you need a platform that can support you with data knowledge sharing, collaboration amongst teams, implementation of governance processes, and full visibility into what's happening at any time. In summary, you need something that can govern and democratize your data in motion to unlock its expansion. What I'm about to show you and what we are releasing today in Confluent Cloud is the beginning of this journey, a truly self-service data in motion platform that has governance embedded by design. We call it Stream Governance, and we build it because we believe this is very important for your success as you move towards being an event-centric enterprise. So for this demo, we're going to put ourselves in the shoes of Francisco. Francisco is an engineer on the data team of the United States Aviation Monitoring Department, also known as FlyWatch. So you, Francisco, and your team, you have a very important job, taking care of the data that keeps us all safe in the skies. So this is fast and furious, real-time sensitive data that informs the position of every aircraft in the US airspace. And naturally, Kafka is this data backbone. Now, it's a Friday night and you're on call as you normally are every month. It's late and you just had a crazy work week. So you're just chilling, watching a nice movie while cuddling your Chihuahua named Streams. Now, as the movie gets into its climax, you get a call. And on the other side, it's your boss yelling about some aircraft data not showing up for the LaGuardia airport monitoring. So what do you do? What do you say? Maybe say it's the wrong number and hang up? Or pass the phone to Streams the Chihuahua? Well, no need for that. Lucky for you, you have Confluent Cloud. And just in time with the new stream governance capabilities that we are releasing today that can help you get back to your movie in no time. All right, so let's do this. Great, so we are now online and looking at the FlyWatch Monitoring Control Center. On the screen are all the airport applications consuming from their respective topics in Confluent Cloud. As we can see, the LGA LaGuardia application screen is blank. So let's quickly jump to Confluent Cloud to investigate more. First thing I'll do is use the new Stream Lineage tool to visualize and understand how event streams are flowing through Confluent. For the first time, I can follow the lineage of my data and stop by anywhere along the way to get more information. Each node on the graph represents a topic or an application that is producing or consuming from a topic like a connector, a KSQL DB query, or your own coded application, and the edges represent the data flowing between them. Note that this graph is built automatically from the activity of producers and consumers of data, with no additional work or instrumentation needed from my side. Confluent is connecting the dots for me. So, starting from the left, I can see all the aircrafts publishing their own location to a topic named aircraft. These are Java applications configured with the Kafka client ID as the actual aircraft ID. Then, subscribing from this topic, I have a Kafka Streams application that is filtering out any PII data like the pilot name. In fact, this application is using the new tagging feature for schema fields to determine which values should be masked. Next, I have a series of KSQL DB queries routing these events to the respective airport topics. Finally, I can see all the FlyWatch applications I showed on the initial control center screen consuming from these topics. One thing I notice immediately is that the LaGuardia topic is not showing up on my lineage. Something must be off with this KSQL DB query. So let me go ahead and inspect this node. Going to the query clause, I can see we are using a field called TrueTrack to filter events. This seems like a good follow-up for me. Using the new stream catalog functionalities, I can now search and discover what TrueTrack is. The catalog takes me to the schema of this field, where I can learn more about this data definition. Schemas are incredibly powerful for governing data in motion. they don't just make explicit the data contracts between producers and consumers, but also power data discoverability since they are a primary source of data information. I found that TrueTrack is tagged as deprecated, and now I have context for why the KSQL DB query is failing. Let me also add the tag do not use to make it super clear for other users to come. Great, so now I can ping the owner of this KSQL DB query to take it from here. This is the end of the story. I used the new self-service governance tools on the platform to successfully help me out this Friday night. I'm super happy. Streams the Chihuahua is barking in happiness. My boss is happy. Everyone is happy. All of this is now live in your Confluent Cloud, so please go and check it out.